Hi, I'm Tara Hitchcock, and you are watching Harkins Theaters Behind the Screens. If you're like me, you grew up watching Kevin Costner, Field of Dreams, Bull Durham, always the lovable guy. Quite the opposite in his new film, Criminal, where he plays a prison inmate whose brain is implanted with the memories of someone else. I sat down with the Oscar winner.
They stuck Billy in my head. I got a scar, see?
If your brain were implanted into mine, what am I in for?
In yours?
Yeah. If I had your brain, yeah. What kind of memories, what are my best
memories?
You'd
be in for a ride. your head would spin, and I guarantee you would have a good time. But you would might be go to some darker places, too, where you go like, Mr. Wizard, bring me back.
If you could have somebody's head for just a minute, who would it be?
Well, I'd desperately like to know what my wife's thinking sometimes. given the way the man-woman thing is, mm-hmm. I go, what in the world?
It's funny you say that, because my husband says, if you could just get in my head, you would understand that that's not what I meant, this is what I meant.
Right, exactly.
You probably go through the same
thing. No, it's biblical. We're all going through the same thing, and we just wonder why. And I think that's why when you're with your girlfriends, you sit and you actually laugh together about stuff that you actually fight with your husband about, right? When you're with your girlfriends, you laugh about it. But when you're with your husband, it's deadly serious. And likewise, when he's with you, it's deadly serious. And then you get with your friends and you go, you cannot believe what the...
If your brain were implanted into my head, what am I in for? What am I gonna get? Good stuff, a combo.
You're gonna get a combo. I think. You're gonna get some good stuff, but you're gonna get some really dark stuff too.
You do have some skills that you didn't know you had. Is there a skill that you wish you did have? I mean, you sing, you write, you act,
well,
you do a lot.
I wish I could draw. I can't. I'm not artistic that way. I can dream up stories, write them, but I wish I could draw what I see because sometimes when I can't explain it, if I could draw it, there would be no mistaking what I'm talking about.
So don't ever have you on a Pictionary team, is
no,
what you're saying.
No, I can't draw an orange.
Oh, come on.
I can't.
He has a total lack of empathy for anybody or anything. He feels nothing.
The scene where you come out of prison and you're kind of experiencing this sensory overload of
right.
things for the first time, to me that's like being a dad. Do you feel that way when your kids go through stuff that brings you back to a time and you feel like you're experiencing this stuff for the first time?
I said when they're all three arguing in the back seat, it is sensory overload, right? And sometimes there's even a video playing up there. So it's like you can't do enough for these kids anymore.
Yeah.
And they're still fighting it. You know what I mean? You just take your fist, you punch the screen up so they can't watch that. I say, you ain't talking anymore.
Yeah. And we never had that. How did we survive? We never had all that stuff.
Well, you did. Your dad said, you look out that side of the window and you look outside of that window and don't touch each other. And of course your hand would be creeping over like this. I mean, what we always know is that almost the best way to handle kids is when they're really fighting is to say, okay, well, just go to your rooms, mm-hmm. separate. And they're happy to do that at first because their anger is whatever it is. But when they really do love each other and you've cultivated love in your house, pretty soon, 15, 20 minutes, they want to get back together.
Yeah.
Jericho Stewart, he's in and out of prison more than half his life. He's got no impulse control.
What makes that fun, playing a bad
guy? I don't
guy?
Know. Hopefully the character is fun to watch. I think it's nice to watch if you felt that it was unpredictable. If you were seeing me do things that you thought, whoa, whether I'm using my teeth to dismantle a car and escape, having a cup of coffee and talking in a foreign language and having great joy of that and then have some putz ruin it for me. And then he has to face a little bit of the criminal.
Remember! Remember!
You got me confused with somebody else.
20 years, JFK, was it 20 years ago? That's just amazing. So to get back on set with these same guys.
Yeah, Kevin and Tommy Lee, there we are, from Dallas to London.
But you guys kept in touch.
You know, occasionally I would run into Kevin, you know. Where was I the last time? I think I was in Vancouver. And I was making a film in Vancouver, and he was passing through with his band, mm-hmm. playing a gig that night.
Did you go?
Didn't go. I was working. But, you know, I've run into him a couple of times over the years. But it was one of the reasons, I think one of the reasons for doing this, apart from, you know, Ariel, the director, who I like very much, you know, was to reconnect with Kevin and do something with him again.
Your name is Bill Pope.
I'm sick, Doc. I need some kind of shot. I need something.
Don't look at him. Don't look at him. He can't help you. Only you can help him. Your name is Bill Pope.
Your career obviously is just storied, and you've had titles from one of the sexiest film stars in history to icon. Is there a title or an honor that actually matters to you?
Dad.
Aw. That's a nice way to end.
Yeah.
We'll end on that note.
There's too many lives at stake. They don't matter.
They do to me.
You mess with me. Thought they knew what they'd get. But they were wrong.
I hope you enjoyed my cast interviews for the film Criminal. I had never met Gary Oldman before. Quiet, subdued, but how do you not love the guy? What a good actor. Hey, don't forget to like us on Facebook, Harkins Theaters, for your movie news, promotions, and giveaways, and everything you need to know about the 2016 Loyalty Cup.